announcement. Reagan said he was not shaken, but later he about-faced on an issue that he strongly opposed for years, calling for strenuous toy gun control legislation. Well, after a long illness, Generalisimo Francisco Franco died Wednesday. Reactions from world leaders were varied. Held in contempt as the last of the fascist dictators in the West by some, he was also eulogized by others, among them Richard Nixon, who said, quote, "General Franco was a loyal friend and ally of the United States. He earned worldwide respect for Spain through firmness and fairness." Despite Franco's death and an expected burial tomorrow, doctors say the dictator's health has taken a turn for the worse.
Good evening. I'm Chevy Chase, and you're not. Our top story tonight, Generalissimo Francisco Franco is still dead. And now, as a public service to those of our viewers who have difficulty with their hearing, I will repeat the top story of the day, aided by the headmaster of the New York School for the Hard of Hearing, Garrett Morris. Our top story tonight...
Our top story tonight...
Francisco Franco is still
Franco
dead.
Is still dead.
Good night and have a pleasant
tomorrow. Good night
tomorrow.
And have a pleasant tomorrow.
This bulletin just in from Madrid, Spain, comes the word that Generalissimo Francisco Franco is still dead. Doctors say his condition is unchanged. This story was just in this afternoon. At a summit conference yesterday, Chinese Premier Zhou Enlai had a high-level talk with Generalissimo Francisco Franco. Among the topics of discussion, Spanish rice. Secretary of State Henry Kissinger, en route to Moscow, will stop at the Miami Super Bowl and attempt to negotiate a settlement between the Dallas Cowboys and the Pittsburgh Steelers. On the way back from Moscow, Kissinger will see King Juan Carlos of Spain and also visit Francisco Franco, who is still seriously dead. Good evening, I'm Chevy Chase, and you're not. Our top story tonight, Generalissimo Francisco Franco has been critically dead now for 11 weeks, and his doctors refuse to speculate on how long he can last in his present condition. And now, as a public service to those of our viewers who may have been in the shower earlier in the broadcast, I will repeat the top story of the day, aided by the chairman of Wet Americans for a Clean Nation, Alan Zweibel. The top story tonight.
Tonight's top story.
Generalissimo Francisco Franco has been critically dead now for 11 weeks.
Dead for 11 weeks.
Good night and have a pleasant
tomorrow.
This just in, Francisco Franco is dead today at the age of 82. It was revealed today that the recent death of Teddy, the koala bear, was a suicide. Zoo officials close to the bear say he really did hate Qantas and that he was despondent over the continuing death of Francisco Franco. The airline gave Teddy a, quote, no-frills burial, consisting of no dinner, no movie, no oxygen, and a soft drink. This just in from Spain, a medical team has announced that Generalissimo Francisco Franco is still valiantly holding on in his fight to remain dead. Still to come, Franco dead after this film message. Well, the political shakeup in Spain continues following the death earlier this year of Generalissimo Francisco Franco. For a live report, let's go now to Madrid and correspondent Lorraine Newman.
Chevy, I'm standing with the press secretary to the late Generalissimo, who has just had a press conference in which he made what he considers to be an important statement. Mr. Boyardi?
Well, I have simply stated to the press, as I have in the past, that the Generalissimo's condition is still very grave, but, and I would like to emphasize this, it is stable at this time.
Mr. Boyardi, Franco is dead, is he not?
Yes, he is. But I didn't say that he wasn't dead. I just said he was stable.
Well, do you foresee any modification in his attitudes?
No, I don't think there's going to be any change in his position.
Mr. Press Secretary, I've noticed that you have no detectable accent.
Yes, that is correct. And neither does the Generalisimo.
I see. Back to you, Chevy.
Lorraine Newman. The 103rd running of the Kentucky Derby takes place next week, and the odds-on favorite is said to be Honest Pleasure. Churchill Downs today reported that it has accepted an entry by Ruffian, the late filly, who is now a three-year-old and finally eligible to run. Insiders believe she will be ridden by jockey Francisco Franco, who, it is said, is finally down to racing weight.
Well, time is running out for Generalissimo Francisco Franco. The Spanish dictator has now held his breath since November 1975. But he still has a long way to go to beat the existing world's record held by his predecessor, Tomás de Torquemada, who has been holding his breath since 1498. Charlie Chaplin's classic comedy film, The Great Dictator, was finally released in Spain this week. The film had been banned during the 40-year reign of Generalissimo Francisco Franco because it made fun of Franco's friend, Adolf Hitler. Hitler could not be reached for comment in Argentina, and sources report that Franco now only watches underground movies. In Spain, new problems for Generalissimo Francisco Franco. His personal doctors have gone on strike, and until they return to duty, no one can guarantee how long the dead dictator can remain in his present condition. And our final story tonight took place today in Montreal, where Generalissimo Francisco Franco scored a perfect 10 out of 10 in the cadaver diving, a relatively new sport in Olympic competition. The former ruler of Spain, now known as El Cadaver, scored an upset over Daniel Gerhardt, ex-mercenary, who was considered to be the favorite until he lost points for his execution. Generalissimo Francisco Franco has spent a restful summer in Spain and plans to remain there for the fall and possibly the winter. In a related note, the United States Health Service has received an interesting request from the Spanish government. Spain would like 20 cc's of swine flu vaccine to inoculate Generalissimo Francisco Franco, who doctors say is quite susceptible to the disease in his present state. Hello? Hello? Who? Oh, yes, I'll accept the charges. Hi, Francisco, how are you? How's your back? Good. No, I'll probably be back and forth. You know how it is. Well, you just put your legs under a pillow. You'll feel much better. Uh-huh. Well, it's good talking to you. Yes. Shall we send you an absentee ballot? Okay. So long now.
And in still another celebration, today marks the first anniversary of the so-called death of Generalissimo Francisco Franco. He, too, has been receiving gifts from all over the world, including dead flowers from Argentina, a candygram from Mao Zedong, and recently acquired Don, Doc, Mr. T, and Tina, as well as a homesick Barbara Walters from the National Broadcasting Company.